Thank you. Good evening and welcome to our concert, the University New Music Ensemble. Thank you for coming. That first piece was called Nocturne, written by a composer from Vancouver, Canada, and it portrays a night mood. And so we hope you enjoyed the restful, peaceful atmosphere of that first piece, Nocturne. We have 8 more to go. Some are similar to this and some are wildly different. So we hope you enjoy them all. Brooklyn Webb will now play. I can't remember. That's why we make programs, so I don't have to remember the titles. Oakland.
Thank you.
next piece is called Postcard from Voyager 1. Now, you may be familiar with NASA, and we send out things. Voyager is X number of light years away from us, sending back data, exploring our non-world. And so on this piece, it's a friend of mine, a composer in Alabama, Everett Minshew, who wrote this, and it is Postcard from Voyager. The track, the piano track that you will hear, represents Voyager. The live musicians in the room that are playing are some of the data that is going back and forth. next one, and it might be our favorite because it has the funnest title to say, Salty Fish Flesh. Come on, isn't that funny? I'll say it again. Salty Fish Flesh. Thank you. It is chaos, as one would imagine, right? It's the oldest piece on our programs, written in the 20th century. And you remember 20th century? This is even before Y2K. This is from 1998. Thank you. This piece, A Light That Draws Near, by Kevin Day. Day writes, I wanted to write something to celebrate the 100th anniversary of the vibraphone, an American invention. So I chose to compose a piece that would highlight the instrument's sonic beauty and timbre. A Light That Draws Near depicts a meditative and peaceful feeling, portraying a sense of calm within the storm that we have all endured in dealing with the pandemic. I wanted this piece to have a feeling of hope that we will eventually reach the end of this time and that the light at the end of this tunnel will continuously draw near. is a piece for three drums, snare drum and two tom-toms, with an accompaniment track that I wrote this in 2020 when I don't remember what I was thinking, but I felt like drumming. And it's called River Run, and I did not run two steps. The river ran, and I was beside it at a certain point down in Bloomington in one of the parks there, right? Caitlin, River Run.
Thank you.
final piece tonight is called Super Heavy. We want to thank you for coming out. We know you could have been anywhere in the world right now, but you decided to spend time with us, and that means everything to us. Thank you. Thanks to all of you streaming there across the world, across our galaxy, I suppose. This piece is I joined a consortium, a group of university professors. Each of us paid a little bit to pay these composers to write some material. And this one is by Susanna Hancock, who says the title Super Heavy comes from her experience in growing up in South Carolina. And I could probably read it, or I could just make things up, maybe. When people ask me about my hometown or my experience growing up there, I can usually sum it up in three words: beach, space, and band. Super Heavy alludes to the first stage rocket booster of the same name for SpaceX's Starship, a rocket system currently in development that is intended to be a rapidly reusable spacecraft. After witnessing the swiftest climb in the area that was once nicknamed the Space Coast when the shuttle program ended, the prospect of Starship and potential revitalization of my hometown leaves me hopeful. As the current model stands, Super Heavy will take the Starships to Earth lower orbit and dislodge, using small bursts of fuel to reverse itself and descend to Earth. For the majority of the trip back, Super Heavy will float quietly to the launch pad that it came from, saving its remaining fuel for a final blast to keep itself from crashing into the launch pad from whence it came. This is an ode to hometown nostalgia. Being able to go to the beach anytime to watch rocket launches from bedroom windows and spending Friday nights carrying Super Heavy drums. Susanna Hancock, 2021, Super Heavy. Thank you.